ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to London's Leicester Square, which tonight plays host to the world premiere of Aquaman! It's an action-packed adventure that takes the audience across the world of the seven seas as one man discovers his true destiny. And tonight, we are destined to meet the incredible cast and filmmakers behind this movie. Joining us on our suitably themed blue carpet tonight, we have the director of the film, Mr. James Wan, will be here. Dolph Lundgren is joining us tonight. Mr. Patrick Wilson will be here. Amber Heard is coming. And of course, Aquaman himself, Jason Momoa, will be here. Have turned out in force for the world premiere of Aquaman, awaiting the imminent arrival of our Atlantean stars and filmmakers tonight. But we're not just joined by fans here in Leicester Square. We are live around the world online with fans in every country joining us for the world premiere. And of course, we want to hear from you. How excited are you about the imminent arrival of our stars this evening and indeed the movie itself? The hashtag you are going to need tonight is hashtag Aquaman, as simple as that. Hashtag Aquaman, get involved. Let us know how excited you are. Taking on the iconic title role of Aquaman, please give a huge London welcome to Jason Momoa! Taking the role of King Orm, please welcome to London's Leicester Square, Patrick Wilson! The role of King Nereus, please welcome to London's Leicester Square, Mr. Dolph Lundgren!
Stars.
please give a huge London welcome to Amber Heard. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm joined now by the one and only Mr. Dolph Lundgren. How are you this evening? How does it feel being here in London for the world premiere of Aquaman?
Fantastic. Yeah. Always nice to be in London. You do the greatest premieres, I think, in the whole world. So it's great to be here with my two lovely daughters, Ida and Greta. They're over there somewhere.
Oh, it's wonderful to have you all here. And tell us a little bit about how you first came to be involved in Aquaman.
Well, I think James Wan was a fan of Masters of the Universe when he was a little kid like this. And my King Nereus looks a bit like He-Man, so I think there's some reason maybe why I got cast for this role. But it was a great role, very good cast, and I think it's a fun movie. And, you know, I haven't seen the picture, so I hope it's good.
So you're seeing it for the first time tonight. You're going to see yourself as King Nereus.
Yes, I will. In my get-up, I hardly recognize myself, but hopefully the film is good, you know.
So tell us a little bit about Nereus and how he fits into the story of Aquaman.
Well, you know, he's a political figure in this movie. It's really about alliances. And King Nereus, whose daughter is Amber Heard in the movie, Princess Mera, he's trying to negotiate with both sides. He's trying to keep peace underwater between the warring factions. But unfortunately, like we do sometimes, we have to join one side at some point. And in this film, I decide somewhere in the line that maybe I joined the wrong side. And because of my daughter, my love for my daughter, and because I worry about her, I decide to start helping Aquaman instead of the other people. So so I made a good decision.
And for you, I mean, there's some incredible action in this. There's this whole adventure. What was the highlights for you of being involved in this movie?
Well, look, it's called dry for wet, meaning you shoot everything on a blue screen, and you're hanging these wires, you know, 40 feet in the air, conducting scenes and action. And for me, I really look up to people that do these superhero movies because it's really difficult. Mm. And the more you weigh, the more the harness pulls on certain areas on the male anatomy. So, you know, after about 4 or 5 hours, you're ready to come down.
Well, thank you for pulling back the curtain on what it's like to make these movies. Ladies and gentlemen, the brilliant Mr. Dolph Lundgren.
Thanks, guys. Thank you.
Bringing his producing talents to Aquaman, please welcome Peter Safran.
Right there.
It's Jason Momoa!
Yeah!
Jason, oh, it's so good to have you here in London. What do you make of this reception?
It's beautiful, finally. Finally, Aquaman's here. It's done.
That's what I was going to ask. I mean, what's it feel like finally having the Aquaman solo movie on the big screen?
I just started this YouTube channel to document this world tour because I found a picture of me walking out of Warner Brothers Studio on September 23rd, 2013, and Zack Snyder told me I was going to play Aquaman. 5 years.
Wow.
Now I'm here.
And here we are. Here we are.
Here we are.
It's amazing. And what a movie. James Wan, what was it like having him bring Aquaman to the big screen in such an incredible fashion?
It's a beautiful journey. It's a magical journey. I think he killed it. I have seen about as much as everyone else here. I'm waiting to see it with my babies.
What?
So everyone here in the UK will see it before me, and I mean, my kids were so stoked to seeing the trailer, and I'm gonna wait till I see it with them so I can hold their hands and sit next to them.
Oh man, that's so cool. That is so cool. Now, what they are gonna see is you doing a lot of your own stunts? If not,
No.
No?
No.
Do you do
stunts? I definitely do a lot of my stunts.
Yeah.
There's so many stunts in this that we had to constantly be prepping for the next stunts. And so I had two stunt doubles constantly working.
What was it like bringing at least some of them to life, though? Because the action in this movie, next level.
It is next level, yeah. I got to see a couple of the fights, and it's unbelievable. I'm very proud of it, and I'm proud of them, and I'm proud of James, and can't wait for the world to see it.
Oh, man. Now, there was a huge gasp when people saw the trailer where you actually put on the iconic Aquaman suit. What was it like for you personally putting on that outfit?
My experience was looking in James Wan's eyes, and his eyes were just delighted, and he was filled with joy. So, I mean, he was constantly just, he was stoked. And so all I could see it on his face, and then I call my kids, and I see it on FaceTime. I see their faces, and it was beautiful.
Oh, man, yeah. That must be amazing. Oh, okay, listen, you've got a big premiere. Do you have a message? We got thousands of fans watching around the world, as well as being here in London's Leicester Square. Do you have a message for them?
I'm very honored to be here because I shot, you know, Justice League here and obviously a little show called Game of Thrones. So I definitely love it here. I'm super pumped to be here, and I'm excited for you to see all my hard work. I love you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Jason Momoa! To the big screen, please welcome director James Wan.
Yes, I knew you would be.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm joined now by the producer of Aquaman, Peter Safran. Peter, lovely to have you here in London tonight.
Thank you very much. It's a dream to be here.
Congratulations on your movie. How do you feel knowing that fans are about to see Aquaman for the first time?
We have waited for over 2 years for this moment to show the world audiences Aquaman. So it's fantastic to be here in London to show them for the first time. It's a dream come true.
That's fantastic. I know people are excited to see the movie. Tell us a bit about why James Wan was the perfect person to bring this vision to the big screen.
You know, James is a consummate fan. James, he's allergic to anything that feels inauthentic. And the fact that he knows exactly what he wanted from the moment he started on this film, he's brought it through to the end exactly as he wanted it. So it's a very exciting time.
I mean, to talk about the movie, there's some incredible action, some incredible creatures. What for you is your personal highlight of Aquaman?
You know, I think I love the trench sequence that you'll remember because you've seen the film.
Oh, yeah.
That to me is a classic old school James Wan scary filmmaking. I love it.
It really is scary.
Yeah.
It's brilliant. And now a little bit about Atlantis itself, because it's an incredible creation. How challenging was it bringing Atlantis to the big screen?
It was extraordinarily challenging. I mean, one of the goals in making this movie was to bring things to the audience that people have never seen before. And so we constantly had that in the back of our minds as that background was being created. And, you know, again, James had this vision for Atlantis. He started from scratch and he came up with this idea for it. And the detail that it took to get exactly what we wanted was painful, but we got there and we're here today.
It may have been painful, but it was worth it because it's an amazing creation. Peter, enjoy
your
world premiere. Lovely to see you here. Peter Safran, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you very much.
Don't Please give a huge Leicester Square welcome to the composer of Aquaman, Rupert Gregson-Williams. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm here now with Peter Gregson-Williams, the composer of Aquaman. Peter, how are you enjoying this incredible world premiere here in London?
I'm really enjoying it. It's Rupert, by the way. Yes, Jason just turned up. It's like we're at Stonehenge.
Sorry, if you could hold the microphone a bit.
Stonehenge, all of a sudden.
Isn't it rock and roll? Isn't it amazing, Rupert? He is a very rock and roll man. Tell us, after Wonder Woman, which you also did the score for, what it was like coming to Aquaman.
Wonderful working with James.
Sorry, if you can hold
James me. Is something special. He's got a vision. I spent some time about a year ago writing some business with him in a room, and the last year has just been a wonderful experience, really.
And how do you begin the process of scoring a film like this?
Spend time with the director. James has a lot to say on the subject. He loves his comics. Loves the character. And then get in a darkened room and try desperately to come up with that theme. And it can take a month, it can take two, but that moment when you play it to the director and he jumps out of his seat, I can't tell you what he says, but it's an exciting moment.
And so was there a certain aspect of Aquaman that you took inspiration for coming up with this score from?
No, really from discussions with James. And I just wanted to differentiate land and under the sea. And the most exciting part for me is obviously under the sea, it's Atlantis. And the moment you see Atlantis, the moment that Jason arrives, Jason and Amber arrive there, is exciting for me. That was the first piece I wrote and the first piece that James loved. Yeah.
And are you looking forward to seeing the movie this evening?
Really, a lot. Yeah. Yeah.
Rupert, congratulations on your work on the film. It's an incredible movie. Ladies and gentlemen, Rupert Gregson-Williams.
Thank you.
Answers I don't want to hear.
and gentlemen, it's the brilliant Mr. Patrick Wilson.
Yeah!
Woo! How are you enjoying this world premiere here in London?
I'm so good. I'm so excited to be here. Every time I come to London, I think this is my... Oh, God, I've been coming here for a long time. But this, to be here for the world premiere, to be with these fans, is unbelievable. I love London, always have, but showing them this film, it's pretty thrilling.
The fans are really excited. So tell us a bit more about King Orm and how he fits into the
King story. Orm, the rightful king of Atlantis, I might add. Well, here's the thing about King Orm that I think by the end of this conversation you'll understand. He is a guy that feels that the surface world has been destroying his oceans, and he wants retribution. I think that's a fair... those are all good reasons.
He's got great reasons.
We do destroy the oceans, and we should take care of it. So, not to be flippant about it, but I think there's a nice little message in there of ocean conservancy and be respectful and understand what we are doing to the oceans, what we have done to the oceans for a long time. Yeah. So that's Orm's fight. There's a little hiccup with his... firstborn half-breed brother that want him to take the throne. It is called Aquaman.
Now, Aquaman in question, Jason Momoa,
yes.
You go toe-to-toe with Jason.
Yes.
Some incredible action sequences. I have to say, he looks like he could handle himself. How was that?
He does, he does pretty well. Yeah. The good thing, here's the thing, and what's actually pretty cool about the way the movie is set up is without giving too much away, underwater is a different story. He's been fighting on land for a long time. Yeah. Those of us who live underwater for a living, you know, we hold our own too pretty well.
Oh yeah, I'd say you hold your own incredibly in this movie. Now you have worked with the director, Mr. James Wan. I think I'm right in saying four times.
This is my fifth time.
This is your fifth time.
Many times.
What is it about that working relationship that keeps you coming back?
We just keep trying to get it right. No, you know, I knew with him on the first Insidious movie that we did, which was nearly 10 years ago, it feels like, that he could do anything. And so when I watch him go from that to Conjuring to the Fast and the Furious franchise, the guy can do anything. I'm just happy to ride along with him. And he also pushes me in places that I... usually if it scares me, I'm down. So for this was the most... physically exhausting movie I've ever done, and to give it a go was thrilling, and he gave me the confidence, and nobody else, you know, for me, James is a guy who nothing scares him, nothing is too daunting for him. He can take the scope of this and still really pare it down to relationships and characters, and you know, those are the things that make the Conjuring movies work so well. And I think that's the thing with this, is you see a great brother relationship, the friction of these two brothers, his relationship with Mira, who's Amber Heard in the movie, their budding sparring romance, and all around, you know, you've got he always leads with character first, and I think that's why he's a great storyteller.
I think you're absolutely right. I think the action in this movie is incredible because of the emotion that's attached to it.
Yeah, well, if you don't care about them, then who cares?
Absolutely, absolutely. Yeah. We care, though. We care.
Right.
We care that you're here in London. Ladies and gentlemen, the brilliant Mr. Patrick Wilson.
Thank you. Enjoy the movie.
Well,
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm now here with the director of Aquaman, Mr. James Wan!
Hello!
Wow. Hey, so good to have you here in London. What do you make of the world premiere for your movie in London?
It's pretty amazing. This is my first premiere here in London, so I'm super excited and very nervous at the same time.
Why is your first superhero movie? How exciting is it to be bringing your first superhero movie to the big screen?
It's exciting. And it's with a character that we've never kind of quite seen it before to this level on the big screen. And that's the aspect that I'm probably most excited about.
It's an amazing movie. And you also, you've got this amazing cast. Tell us what it was assembling them.
From Momoa, Amber, Patrick, Dolph, Willem, Nicole. I can keep going on and on. I've just been so lucky to be able to assemble such a great team. You know, they bring so much weight to the film, and they're basically the beating heart of the movie, the emotion of the movie.
And the beating heart of the beating heart, if that makes sense, is obviously Mr. Jason Momoa himself. Tell us how perfect he is taking the role.
I mean, listen, when I first met Jason, I was like, man, this guy's full of charisma. So charismatic. I'm going to have to bring that out on screen. And he's just great. Jason's been such a trooper. You know, it's a tough movie to shoot. Lots of action. And I put my actors through really rigorous sort of technical process to try and simulate the underwater sort of look. And everyone just did such a great job. And Jason is such a physical guy, and he really gets in there, and he's so passionate about it. And he really makes Aquaman his own.
I mean, the one thing I have to say about this movie, visually, it is unbelievable to look at. You've got these incredible creatures, incredible worlds that you've built. For you, what is your favorite? Do you have one part of this movie that you've built that you go, wow, I'm proud of that?
I don't necessarily have one favorite sort of scene or sequences. I have a lot of them. I really enjoy them. Making this movie was tough. It was such a pain to make it, but I had so much fun making it, and a big part of the fun was designing the world, creating lots of the different visuals, and creating things that we have never quite seen before. And I think it plays different to your traditional superhero film. If anything, it plays more like an action adventure fantasy film. And I think the movie is kind of unique for that.
Oh, it is. It's a great film, and congratulations on it. Enjoy the rest of your world premiere.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the brilliant Mr. James Wan.
Thank you.
Woohoo!
Crossfire, yeah.
ladies and gentlemen, an incredible outfit. It's Amber Heard! Lovely. Lovely to see you here in London, Amber. How are you?
Thank you. I'm great.
Yeah? Yes. What do you make of this incredible world premiere here in London town for the movie Aquaman?
This is the way to see this movie. This is so fun. I love being here. This is one of my favorite places to open a movie because the fans, the energy, it's infectious. I'm so glad to be here.
Well, what you could do for us is tell us a little bit more about Mira because she's a great character.
Mira is a badass woman.
Yeah.
She is. When I first got introduced to her, I was sold, at least interested, on the fact that she was a warrior queen. Mm-hmm. And as I say, I heard that and I asked, do I get a sword and a crown? Yeah, I'll get behind that.
Tell us a bit more about Mira's relationship with Aquaman and how they come together in the film.
You know, they have a very strong, you know, kind of brother-sister camaraderie. You know, they do a lot of bickering. They are quite literally from different worlds. And so they have to really earn each other's trust and respect and love. And they have to work together in worlds that are not their own, whether it's on land or in the sea, and they teach each other a lot, and they're a really good pair. And I like that this movie is modern. Mara's not a damsel in distress.
No.
She doesn't need anyone's help. She is a badass, empowered superhero in her own right. So I'm so excited to play this role.
Oh, well, that's cool, because what really comes across is the chemistry that you and Jason share in those moments. Mira's really funny, and like they have this great chemistry. What was it like working with him on the film?
You know, Jason and I lucked out on this one. I could not have asked for a better co-star. He is so much fun. His energy and his enthusiasm and his joy is contagious and infectious, and that's what you need. You really need that, not only in this character or as a person, but on sets when you're filming for, you know, 18 hours a day and doing it for 7 months at a time. It can be grueling. So we have a really natural rapport, and I think it really comes across on screen too.
It really does. And the man who put you through your paces is just over there, director James Wan.
Yes.
What was it like working with him? Because he's delivered an incredible film here.
He's awesome.
That was the director, Mr. James Wan, declaring how awesome he is. And
yes,
he is.
Yes, he is actually quite awesome. He's so much fun. He's a true comic book nerd. And I love that. From day one, I was like, I trust this person to tell this story.
Yeah. Fantastic. So good to see you here. Once again, what an incredible outfit. Ladies and gentlemen, the brilliant Amber Heard.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, sadly, that is all the time we have from here at the world premiere of Aquaman in London's Leicester Square. Our guests and stars have just taken their seats inside, ready to be whisked away to the world of the seven seas. All that's left for me to do is say do check this movie out when it hits cinemas very soon. Good night.